Dear learners, after covering the National OER Repository of India, let's discuss the international repositories. Let's begin with the very first, Google Scholar. You know, Google is the most widely used search engine, and its Google Scholar is a ready source of scholarly articles, and it is free to use. You must use the advanced search, as we have earlier also mentioned, and filter your result as per the time or the licenses. For just a quick recap, you just have to go to the Scholar, not Google. Please remember, refer Scholar. Type whatever you want. Like say, for example, hair loss. We type, we got a list of articles in the left navigation bar. You can filter them with respect to the time, type of articles. You can also get the related article links here, citation information. You can also access the author profile and access all the publication of a particular author to whom you want to refer in a single platform. You can come to know the potential of author by using this profile, as we have discussed in detail earlier also. The next feature is that you can search the images also. Like if you want to search for Himalayan deer image, it will show a number of images. If you want to go for the free to reuse, you will have to free to reuse image, you will have to go to the advanced search and then click the that particular filter, then you will get the image which you can reuse without violating any copyright. The Creative Commons figures will be there. Now the next platform is Google Classroom. As the Scholar, a classroom is another feature by the Google. How to access? If you are having a Gmail ID, go to the right top corner, those 9 bullets, click there, you will find the classroom here, the Google Classroom. Open it. This will show like this page. You can identify yourself as a teacher or student. In the Google Classroom, the beauty is that you can create very easily any kind of assignment, question, and reuse the post. You can sort them topic-wise. It is a very effective and very user-friendly interface in which you can develop the assignments, the reports, the questions, and offer to your students or among your. You can prepare the things in your research. You can prepare the documents for your research collaborators. Now the next is Creative Commons. As we discussed, from copyright to copyleft, the Creative Commons is that NGO, that foundation which is working for copyleft movement. This is the website of Creative Commons. In the Creative Commons, you can share your work, use and remix of the available work, and have your own account there. In the Creative Commons, as you can see on the website, so many available features are there, or available platforms, links are there, which you can use freely. Like Flickr, Bandcamp, Wikipedia, YouTube, Vimeo, Plus, etc. So what is the advantage? That You can get all the free platforms under one single umbrella. It would make it easy to search Creative Commons items or the contents which are not covered in a particular copyright. In the similar way, another platform is there, that is OER Commons. This is the website of OER Commons. It is meant for exploring, creating, and collaborating. You can create your own account in the OER Commons. For that, you will have to register yourself by putting your entries of name, email, password, and after that, you will have your own page, own account, in which you can refine your search on the basis of educational standards, subject area, educational level, material type, conditions of use, content source, primary user, media format, educational use, language, etc. It covers a lot of subjects like arts and humanities, business and communication, career and technical education, English language, history, law, mathematics, physical science, etc. It also provides various network hubs by the various universities, links to free repositories by the major universities and institutions is given in the OER Commons. What you can do? You can develop your OER. You can submit it into the OER Commons in the form of resource builder, lesson, in the form of resource, lesson, or the module. We have given the link how to search in the OER Commons. After you develop modules, your page looks like this. This is my page of OER Commons. The modules are available with free access. So let me summarize this section for you, that we covered the major repositories like Google Scholar, Google Classroom, Creative Commons, and OER Commons in this section. We will discuss other sections in the next module.